had another life, I would never walk straight. All the things I love to do, other people love to hate. With my shoes on my ears and my hat on my feet, park the car in the kitchen, take a bath in the street. I love ping pong, I love bumps, I love the Three Stooges and those crazy drums. I like lovers who don't vote the same. I lie on my bed in the stars and the rain. Oh yeah. If I had another life, I would run, run, run. Run, run, run. Have some fun. But seriously, if I had another life, I would run for president. Feed the pigeons in the park, never pay the rent. Jerry Garcia, Secretary of State, declares money illegal. Now wouldn't that be great? I love ping pong, I love bumps, anchovy pizza and those crazy drums. I like lovers who don't vote the same. Lying on my bed in the stars and the rain. Oh yeah. Ooh, oh yeah. Now, if I had another life, I would do it all again. Run a movie from the middle, begin, get the end. Try to miss the target and win the biggest score. Tell my dad I love him like I never did before. I love ping pong, I love buns, I love the honeymooners and those crazy drums. I like lovers who don't vote the same. Talking to my father in the stars and the rain. Another life. If I had another life, if I had another life.
Yeah. We're just about ready. Okay, if people want to view, if you've not used the webinars before, if you go into gallery view, it's normally in the top right, the little multi-blocks, you should be able to see sort of a full screen page view of the other participants. Unfortunately, Nenad doesn't get sent to stage then, but as soon as he starts talking, I think you'll guess, you know who, which one that is. So otherwise, let's get going.
Okay.
So, welcome. This is the first webinar we've had on behalf of Ping Pong Parkinson's in the UK, because I became a designated ambassador after asking Nenad who to contact for me to join the British squad. Apparently there isn't one, but that's my mission now to create that. So there's a lot to pack into this talk. And as I said earlier, Nenad's happy to take questions as we go along. So if you want to just mute yourself in the meantime, but if you've got a question, just come off mute yourself and shout out and make it interactive as we go. So I'd just like to thank Parkinson's UK for hosting this webinar and for their ongoing support with Team Parkinson's. And I'm delighted to introduce Nenad Bach, a very talented Croatian-American. He's a recording artist, composer, performer, producer, peace activist, and who also happens to play ping pong. So Nenad, over to you.
I would never walk straight. All the things I love to do, other people love to hate. With my shoes on my ears and my head on my feet, park the car in the kitchen, take a bath in the street. I love ping pong, I love bumps, I love the Three Stooges and those crazy drums. I like lovers laying on my bed in the stars and the rain. Oh yeah. If I had another life, I would run, run, run. Run, run, run. Have some fun. Here we go. Well, welcome everybody. I'll put the guitar on the side. So that we are done with this.
Grand opening, sir. Grand opening.
Thank you. So can we ask the people the poll, if you can, Andrew, can you go and ask people questions? Yeah, well, the reason, maybe you wonder why I ask you these questions. The reason is the order of magnitude. I think it's crucially important that we know the order of magnitude. I would have this as a subject in the school for people to learn, to know the order of magnitude. That we, for example, I wanted to, there are three goals of Ping Pong Parkinson. First is to help people immediately to have better lives. So since I started to play ping pong, I feel much better, much, much better, 50% better. Second is we need to animate scientific community to find out why is that good, or why is it good for us, and maybe find the cure through this research. And third is we want to participate in Paralympic Games. We want to participate in para games, period. We don't have access to this. And the reason why, it's just pure bureaucracy. They say that it takes 10 years. It doesn't take 10 years. It takes few people to agree on it, because if multisclerosis can be part of it, why not we? So if we are united and we demand this, we will get it. I pitched even for 2021 in Tokyo, even if as a pilot or something, but that we have to be present. Because we have been denied this opportunity. So I will briefly, I will tell you a little bit about history of ping pong Parkinson's.
And mostly before you go on, can I interrupt you, Nenad? Sorry about that. Yeah. Just going back, is there an opportunity as well? Have you done anything with the Commonwealth Games in 2022, which has been held in Birmingham in the UK?
Well, no, but let's do it.
Good. All right. Well, let's follow up that. Afterwards.
Absolutely. So how did I start it? I was diagnosed with Parkinson in 2010. Now this is what I wanted to say. You all can read a little bit, or already read something about me and saw videos and things like this. So I would like to use my time mostly to hear from you about what your needs are, how you think to organize, and that's what I think most of the time should be spent, not me talking about myself. But I will give you a few words about what happened, how it happened. In 2010, I was diagnosed with Parkinson. And 5 years later, I stopped playing guitar publicly because I couldn't play syncopation. As I show you in the song, for example, just to give you an example, this is syncopation. This is downbeat, and this is syncopation. So it's and I could not. It's too complex for the brain. You have to sing the words. That's too complex for the brain. I just could not play it. I stumbled and then I stopped playing, performing live. Then a friend of mine introduced me to ask me to go and play ping pong with him in 2015, 16, something like that. I played one night, and next day I felt much better. And I said, well, maybe it could be by accident, but I went again to the club, Westchester Table Tennis Club in Pleasantville, New York. So we continued playing, and I, after deciding to play 2-3 times a week, I've seen major change, and in 6 months I could play guitar again. So that's how breakthrough was it for me. And since it happened, I happened to be introduced to Zoran Primorac,
seven-time Olympian table tennis champion, who I think is joining us. I'm not sure if he's here or not, but he can wave if he's already here.
I'm here.
Okay,
I'm
wonderful.
Yeah, I'm here. Continue. You can show
the photo if you want. But anyway, Zoran introduced me to the president and CEO of the IDTF, and in 2018, in Sweden, I made a presentation for Ping Pong Parkinson to be world championship. And in 2019, only a year later, we had the world championship. And now the word is spreading around. It's like wildfire. We have 27 clubs open in Germany. I hope that Thorsten is here also from Germany. We are planning championship. First one is in Germany, in Berlin, next year in April, then Croatia, then Brazil, then Japan. So things are moving fast, and people see the benefits of it, and we would love to share that with everybody else. If it helped us, I think it will help other people. So that's basically it. There is film to be produced about the championship and about the whole story. There is a book. You can show the artwork, if you don't mind, Andrew. This is an artist from Barcelona, Ignasi Blanc. I don't know if you are here or not, but you can wave if you are here. And this is the background behind me. Yes, hello, Ignacio. And this is beautiful.
Hello. Take care.
Okay, wonderful. So this is also artwork behind me. That's Ignace artwork. So we are on multi-platform. We are trying to tell to the world that we are here, we exist. And this is the way that we can help other people. So I'm open for the questions. Hello, Ignace.
Nenad, can I ask something? It's Keith. Yeah. You said that the first time you played ping pong, that you felt better the next day. What?
Yes.
So I have two questions, really. One is, can you be like more specific about how you felt better? Was it your mood, or was it very specific things to do with movement? And also, did it continue to get better the more you played? You know, did you get better to a certain level as you played more?
Yes, it was first mild, so I shook less. My posture was better, my cognitive was better, I could speak better. I was not stiff as I used to be in the morning, so everything was better. And then, in percentage wise, maybe I would say 15% first time I played once. But when I continue to play twice or three times a week, then it became 50%. So it's a huge difference. And as I said, this syncopation, I could play or I could not play. That's the big difference for me. That was like a breakthrough for me to understand that playing ping pong, because these are reflexes. You have to act in less than a second. You have to react. So there is no thinking. The brain has to. So either I rewired old neurons in my brain, or I created new ones. Nobody knows. But something out of these two things happened.
Can I ask you something? You say you felt better. Was that because of the exercise or because of the coordination?
Well, I don't know.
Because I suffer with Parkinson's myself, and I'm an extreme cyclist. I cycle all over the world, and I feel just like you do after I finish my exercise for cycling or whatever I do. That is what I'm asking. Is it because of the coordination of hitting the ball?
I really don't know. I would say because
they do say exercise is one of the best things possible for Parkinson's.
That's true. I would say boxing is good. Every exercise is good. Tango is good. But what is specifically good about ping pong is that this is a split second making decisions. Cycling, you don't need to do the, you pedal, but in
not necessarily.
You have to jump, and that's quick reactions. That's where you rewire your neurons. They have to learn new paths. You have to create new paths for that, and that's very unique. And also, anybody can play ping pong. Anybody, regardless of the level. So it is. Grandparents can play with the grandchildren, and equally.
So Nenad, does a question come up about if there's any specific research to do with table tennis?
Well, there was a research in Japan at the university, but only for 6 months. And here is, they have research here with Ian Marshall. Ian, do you want to say something about it?
They carried out about 20 years ago extensive research in Japan on dementia, which there is obviously a coordination with Parkinson's, and they do believe that table tennis helps. But of course, the more you will play the sport, whatever the sport is, you will improve, because unknowingly you will receive signals from your opposing player. So if you take Zoran Primorac, who's played hours and hours and hours, when somebody serves to him, he maybe doesn't know it, but he reads signals from the opponent, which means that he can react quickly. So whatever the situation is, the more you practice, the more you play, that should improve your coordination. It should help.
Yeah.
Certainly in Japan, they are convinced that table tennis, the coordination, perhaps the fact that you are very close to your opponent and that you have minimal time to react, does maybe not improve reaction, but it would improve anticipation.
Yeah. By the way, for those who don't know, Ian Marshall is a legendary journalist for table tennis, and he wrote extensively from the very beginning, support ping pong Parkinson. And this is a way for me to publicly thank you so much for doing
thank
this.
Thank you.
And there's a comment in the chat box here from, is it Torsten Bohm? Doctors and scientists. Maybe, is Torsten here? Do you want to read, or shall I read it?
He can read it.
I do not remember exactly. There was a research in Japan, and they tested 12 Japanese people, I have to say, about 70 years old. It's a little bit specific, and they had increased in different exercises, so I cannot tell from my mind. I will search the text. I wrote it in German. I wrote it down in German. Let's see if I have a translation in English. I have no idea.
Okay, you can send it, and then we'll share it with everybody else.
I'm on holiday, so please don't be angry about me. I'm not prepared for this.
Yeah, Thorsten is my partner in the whole thing, and we are organizing. There are 27 clubs in Germany that are opening, and 30. Okay.
There was one in the chat box from Adam saying, did you improve in combination with other exercises, or was it just ping pong?
It was just ping pong for me. I boxed a little bit, but my problem is with boxing is it's boring to me. How many times can you punch a bag? Anyway, for me, ping pong was the most the joyful game. And I just got hooked. I enjoyed this spinning ball and in the air, and it's just like cats, you know. Cats never box, but they play with the ping pong ball.
Question, Keisha, about clubs being set up. So I know there's at least two people on the call who are in the process of setting up table tennis sessions for their own branches, or that's been held up a bit because of the COVID. I just wondered if there's anybody else on the call who's been through that process and offer some advice maybe for those about to set up those clubs.
Nenad, I think the answer here is organise a competition. Even if just four players enter, organise something, then people like myself have something to write about. organize some sort of competition in anything, four players, five players, six players, then there's something to write about. And then you can spread the message. More will come, more people will learn. Somebody else will organize a tournament for four or five players. It doesn't have to be the World Championships.
Yeah. Well, we are planning a lot of tournaments, but the COVID-19 got in the way. But definitely, we will. That's the focus. That's the focus.
Yeah. But Nenad, I don't think you need to be precise. Organize a tournament on your dining room table outside. Find some solution. You can play table tennis anywhere. But what I'm saying is that even if you don't play on a full-size table tennis table, find somewhere to play. Get four or five people together, take their photograph, put it on the website, and then somebody else sees that. They try. If you have a competition, there's something to write about. Yes. I mean, the value of Ping Pong Parkinson and Parkinson's for table tennis, we've now been writing about for 2 years. We're well aware of that. Now we have to go to another stage to keep promoting and have some competitions, anything at all.
Yeah, I agree.
And that sort of answers one of the questions from Scott, was how did you organize and spread the word about Ping Pong Parkinson's in the US?
Well, first we studied at the Pleasantville, New York, with the sessions every Wednesday, 7:30 p.m. And we had 150 sessions in a row, regardless of snow or rain, 150 in a row. And so the word spread. I had local television, local newspapers, and word of mouth. So we went to, then I had two neurologists from New Jersey and from New York, and they helped me organize in Westwood, New Jersey, where in the first session we had 20 people with Parkinson in the first session. And we had six sessions, and then COVID happened. So we have another opening in Pearl River in New York. As soon as COVID ends, we will open another. But basically it's a word of mouth, or what Ian said, we were doing it. I know that a lot of people discouraged me to wait till I get 10 people, till I get 15 people. And I said, no, we are starting March 1st, 2017, and that's it. And everything went well after that. So just by doing it. And thank you for asking the question, Scott.
Now, I think, Nenad, one thing that you could do and people could do is go to the local school, go to the local university and see if the 15 or 16-year-old students or 19, 20-year-old students would organise a Parkinson's tournament. Good education for them. And as I say, don't worry if you don't have perfect conditions. Don't worry if you break the rules, but play, and that brings publicity.
Absolutely. The way in Germany was a little bit different. We found people with Parkinson's and searched the clubs then. If you find a club and you have one person at least, you will find more people with Parkinson's who join them.
Exactly.
That's a fact. And that's what made us to 30 clubs now, some with only one person with Parkinson's and some with 25. So about 120 people with Parkinson are playing table tennis from Ping Pong Parkinson now in Germany.
I was going to chip in terms of ideas, because one thing I found going around the local Parkinson's branches promoting research, just using table tennis as an example, putting up one of those impromptu nets on a little dining room table, it really brought the audience alive. You know, one chap not played for 57 years, but he picked up a bat and was able to... take part. As you say, anybody can do that. And I know in Peterborough, there's a lady on the chat here tonight, they've got over 50 people from their branch who said they'd be interested in playing Parkinson's, and so they're just now waiting for things to ease off to be able to actually implement that. So, and there's plenty of others within the Parkinson's UK TT network, of which most of the people on this call and others are already joined in, and welcome to the rest of you if you want to carry on and
I want to ask you a question. Is there maybe Fega from Michael J. Fox Foundation? Are you here? If you're here, we can wait.
Hi, Nenad. How are you? Hi, everybody.
Pretty good. Tell us a little bit about your organization or something.
I work for the Michael J. Fox Foundation for Parkinson's Research in the United States. And our mission is to find a cure and find better symptomatic treatments for Parkinson's disease. So hearing all of this feedback from all of you is like, it's really amazing to see that you have such a great, strong community in the UK. And I hope you don't mind that I've sort of been eavesdropping today, but it's always informative for me. So thank you.
Thank you for joining us. Scott, do you want to say something?
Well, I was just thinking maybe it should be a bigger picture rather than restrict it to Parkinson's condition. Maybe include other people with any neurological condition and we get the numbers up, you know?
I agree. Maybe Alzheimer's as well. Yeah, I agree with that. But it's a start, and we will open more.
Sure.
You're welcome to open at this time, and I think it's a very good point. Absolutely.
Can I jump in, Nenad, and just pick up on Scott's sort of idea. And Keith McIntosh, you've put in the chat, the Alzheimer's Society has launched a partnership with Table Tennis England as part of their Power of Ping Pong project. And Andrew, I just wanted to jump in and maybe you wanted to talk a little bit about the conversations and meetings we've had with Table Tennis England on a similar partnership opportunity. Do you want to just fill everyone in on that? Because we had to hold off on it, didn't we?
Yeah, we're within a few days of making the announcement back in the beginning of April, we talked with Table Tennis England and to promote their ping and bat and chat type program, which is a very informal introduction, not quite full-blown exercise program, although it can be if you wanted to introduce that, but it's as much about the social interaction and as well as the exercise, which is beneficial in itself as well. So we'll kind of re-explore that. As well as on the exercise front, there's a gentleman, Steve Rowe, who's working on a specific exercise program for Parkinson's and table tennis that could be introduced as part of that into the mix as well.
Yes, we are developing aerobics for ping-pong Parkinson. And Steve, if you have a minute or two to say something, if you want.
Well, we'll be getting Steve on another call when that program's more developed. We'll be having another session like this to promote what's going on there.
Okay. I have a question for maybe Steve from US, Tchaikovsky. If you want to say something, you're welcome.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
My name's Richard Ellis. I'm from South Wales.
Hello.
Hello. Has anybody given you any sort of answer to why, for example, in the morning, because of my tremor, I can hardly put my breakfast into my mouth, get my cereal into my mouth. However, when I pick up a table tennis bat, I can hit a ball coming towards me at 40, 50, 60 mile an hour and return it as if there's no problem at all.
Yeah, because if you would dance to your refrigerator, you don't shake when you move. You see, when you move, you don't shake. It's a tremor when you don't move, then it's a tremor. So, right. I would say if you dance with your spoon, sort of speaking, then you shake less. Try that. You know, just if you dance to your refrigerator, you would not shake. So it's an only static tremor when you, how would you say?
Resting tremor.
Resting tremor.
There's another solution. Eat your breakfast with your table tennis bat.
It's Paul on the call because he's got some good videos on Twitter that shows that effect. He can barely walk, but if he puts a ball on the floor, something to focus on, it can move much more fluidly. It's incredible, sort of.
That's the point I was trying to get over, Andy, was the fact that when I play table tennis, it's as if my Parkinson's disappears, and suddenly my speed sort of builds up. My accuracy builds up. I can return balls. Yet when I stop playing and the tremor comes back and my body slows down.
Yeah. It'd be just amazing if we could tap into that and turn it on and off ourselves, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
So that's why this second point of mine, that we have to animate the scientific community to look thoroughly through this. Why is playing ping pong improves our life? So I'm forming a team, but it's very slow. But I'm forming a team of people who will look into it.
Could I jump in at that point?
Yes.
I'm Phil Wood. I come from near Peterborough, and in our little village, we have table tennis every Tuesday afternoon, usually attended by 15 to 20 people. Almost everybody's 60, 65 plus. And there are at least two Parkinson's members of the club. And I'm also aware that in most conurbations, Peterborough is a good example, there are at least two table tennis clubs, just waiting, in fact, to be tapped into, I suspect. I know that Ruth, our chairman, has been in contact with at least one of those clubs, and there's a potential for something to be set up for the new, well, after we've got rid of the virus and so on. But I suspect that applies to most, as I say, conurbations, that there are table tennis clubs just waiting to absorb potential members.
Yeah. I mean, Nenad, why do people play table tennis? They want to play in a competition. They don't want to go to coaching and things like that. They want to play in a competition. Now, if you want to get people to play, organise a competition. Break the rules, it doesn't matter, but organise a competition. And then you create enthusiasm. They'll want to come for another competition next week. And don't worry if only three people play. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. Well, that applies to us for sure. People turn up and say, well, I haven't played table tennis for 50 years. I last did it when I was 14. But they soon get into it. And it's amazing. 3 or 4 weeks later, they're saying, oh, that's really done me a power of good. And I want to continue. Exactly. So. Yeah.
There was a question whether we play doubles or just singles. I saw the question on the screen. We played doubles and singles, and with COVID, we stopped playing doubles. Only individual we are playing. But otherwise, there was a doubles tournament also. We used, and we quite a lot we play doubles. It's a really pleasure.
There was a question in the chat here from Nicola and Andy. How long do you play for in a session?
Hour and a half.
And also another question, would it be beneficial to have a ping pong coach attend? Do you play singles or?
We have a coach. We have a coach all the time. So who instructs us, try to correct us.
And that's where by joining up with your local Table Tennis England club, they've got people that can support that and provide that service on a volunteer or some other basis. But there are people out there that be willing to help you.
And how long were the sessions, Nenad?
Hour and a half. That's what we have. But also people come earlier and leave later. So could be between hour and a half and 2 hours. We started with 1 hour first.
Yeah.
And then we saw that people who wanted to play more, so we extended to hour 15 and then hour and a half. And I sometimes play 4 or 5 hours, but I exhaust myself totally. Cramps during the night.
That's our experience with our table tennis club, that we play for an hour and a half, 2 hours, and it goes on as long as people want to stay and play. I'd be very interested to hear how you're coping with COVID and what arrangements you're making to distance and all the requirements for that. We're not playing at the moment.
Yeah, we are not playing at the moment. Just one-on-one we are playing. We agreed that we'll meet at the club one-on-one. But But otherwise, we have a procedure. We'll measure the temperature. We will wash the balls and wash the racket pedals, disinfect them, and we will keep the 6 feet distance at all time. And everybody has to wear masks. Everybody has to wear a mask all the time.
Yeah, and again, I'll share the Table Tennis England advice. There's a 5-stage return to play schedule. I think you're on stage 2 at present. So that will give you some ideas of what you'd need to do. At the present, I think they're advocating it's still outside play, which is, say, there are a few public places around the UK, or I'm surprised how many people actually have tables tucked away in their garages and not being used for a while. So just ask around.
A couple of questions here about how people went about setting up their clubs locally. So there was one to Ruth.
It's simple. You ask somebody at the club whether they want to play ping pong and if they have Parkinson. So just do it. Just organize the one night a week and see what happens. We started with one night. Now we have one during the day, one during the night. And people come two, three, four times a week. Depends who. But just start with anything. As I mentioned, I started with just myself, and I didn't know whether anybody will come. And 4 people came or 5 people came, and then eventually we have 30 people. So, but consistency, you know, you come at the same time in the same week, and set up the time. Set, you will find volunteers who will play with you who are better than you, because you always wanted to play with people who are better than you. And it's a joy. It's a fun to play.
Okay, can I ask a question?
Sure.
If I'm listening to this and I've never played table tennis before in my life, now I'm interested in playing, how would I go about it?
Well, just go to the club.
What club?
Take a rec.
What club? Do, where?
Do you have club close by?
John, that's where the Parkinson's Table Tennis UK group are here to try and help you with that. So
Exactly. Yeah, this is just for information, you know. So if somebody was listening, they'd be able to sort of cope onto it and think, oh, well, that's a good idea. I'll do that.
That's exactly what this group set up for, is just to connect people up either with each other. There's already groups formed in South Wales, Brighton, Essex and Suffolk around London. As well as a few individual players that are looking for others to join in South Yorkshire and dotted around.
So you'd look on the on Google, would you, or would you go on to?
No, just join get in touch with our group, and that's what I'm trying to reach out to the Parkinson's community to come through PPTTUk just as a
connection. Also Google is good. You can Google it as well. And there is another way to do it, by the way. You get the table tennis and play it at home. Start the club at home or in your village or little town or your community, or you start it somewhere, kitchen table, anything.
Buy a cheap net on eBay for about £10. You get a couple of bats, a ball and a net that clips to your dining room table, and away you go.
We'll send you a racket and the ball.
And remember Digna. I don't think Digna's here this evening.
She is on the call under Adam Baines.
Where are you, Digna? Digna. Go for it, Digna. Lovely to see you.
Yeah, nice to see you too. Yes. Well, I decided to play table tennis because I couldn't play any other sport because there was something wrong with my body. And so I joined the Lewis Table Tennis Club. But it's only once a week. But then I wanted to, I was enjoying so much that I wanted to improve. So I joined the Brighton Table Tennis Club and I play with other people. I don't think there were other person with Parkinson there, but everybody was so helpful and they didn't mind that I wasn't as good as they were. So I improved a lot, and the more I improved, the more I wanted to play, and that helped me, as Nenad was saying, with my coordination. And I could play for 3 hours, 3.5 hours without stop. You know, I had this amazing energy, and after I left the club, I could walk perfectly. You know, I wasn't
wobbling.
Nothing. So it's great. But the other point that I would like to, because there is a group here in Lewis, who someone set up for people with Parkinson's. So I've been trying to tell the person who runs it, you know, the benefits of Parkinson, of table tennis with Parkinson's. And he doesn't seem to be very interested, but I keep on trying. But I don't know how to, as you were saying, you know, someone was saying that you can play and make a competition, but we need a venue and then tables, you know. How do I get that? Is there any funding? How does it work to start so people with Parkinson's can come to the club? Because they don't come to the Lewis Table Tennis Club.
So there is a club in Maribor, Slovenia. Somebody saw the World Championship and they opened the Ping Pong Parkinson in the table tennis club. If you just look somewhere around you, I bet you will find some little club or little venue that has tables. And that's like a nucleus, that's where you start somewhere. And then you spread to a larger place if there are more people. Or you have abandoned spaces in a retirement homes or something like that, or community places, or old dance halls or something like that. You know, if there is a desire, there are plenty of spaces somewhere. And tables are very cheap to get by, or somebody will even donate table. So we will help you whichever way we can if you find the place and space. I bet there are people who will help.
Well, as I said before, many of the sports centres around the UK, when they do open up again, have got tables that you can hire for, say, £5 an hour, something like that, typically. So, you don't need to buy one, or, as I say, just buy your own net to clip on your own table in your...
I'm Ruth from Peterborough, and as Andrew mentioned earlier, we're one of the branches that are due to set up a club very soon. We're all very excited about it. And I just wanted to share with you, as somebody's just mentioned, one of the ladies on here tonight, one of my members, Tracy Foreman, actually did a fundraising event for us to raise the money. And it's great for social media. They like a nice story like that. And the money's actually going towards helping set up our table tennis club. And also to keep it in the media light, we're having a competition to suggest a name for the club. And we're going to give a Parkinson's mug as a prize. So we're trying to drip feed it in as we go through the year to make it a really big splash. And I think it's great after COVID, and hopefully next year when we're all clear of it, it would be really nice to launch our branch again for 2021 with the Parkinson's table tennis group. So it's all very exciting. So I'm going to say fundraising is great to get social media coverage. And thank you for Tracy for raising the money as well. And just want to mention about the venue. We're very lucky that our local Salvation Army has a venue we use. And we're also going to keep our table tennis table there. So they're going to store it for us. And we're going to let some of their charities use the table tennis table as well. So we'll be helping other charities as well.
Excellent. So Ruth, send us your town name properly spelling, and we'll send you a logo. Immediately.
With Peterborough, perhaps I'll get Andrew to pass that on for you, if that's all right, Andrew.
Can I just add something as well? Yes. I set up a Parkinson's football team down here in Wales, and I just went to the local authority and I said, listen, we're going to start up a football team. We got no money. And they actually had a department that were helping sort of disabled groups. And they gave us, 12 footballs. They gave us a pile of shirts and things like that. And they give us free access to the pitches, the indoor pitches. And I'm sure a lot of local authorities in the UK would do the same for table tennis.
In my opinion, in my experience in life, people are really helpful. There are always good people to help you when you need it. So you just have to ask. Well, I thank you so much, Andrew and Parkinson Organization of UK. I love what I've seen. I love what I heard. And we have to be connected, because together we are stronger. And it's a supportive group. It's not just fun. Mm-hmm. We have a mission. We have a mission to accomplish. We have to help 10 million people who cannot play ping pong. And we are playing for them. And we have to be part of the Paralympic Games. And we have to engage scientists to find a cure. That's our goal. And if you believe that world peace is possible, you can read worldpeace.com.
Yeah. Excellent. Well, thank you, Nenad. If people just show your appreciation for great talk. Thank you for giving us your time.
Yeah, thanks for joining, yeah.
And thanks, well, thanks to everybody for joining in as well, because like I say, we're here to help each other. And that's what Parkinson's PDUK has been set up, just to network, really, share this learning, help each other, and also get together so we can have a bigger competition. But in the meantime, as Ian said, just do what you can locally, and just keep on going. For future talks, for those, we talk about the World Championship, just as sure as Nenad, it's not quite as serious as the name kind of gives. It is more just solidarity and an excuse for getting together, like I say, over a good game of ping pong. When the Berlin details are known and registration formally opens, Jans Grieve from UVEDU, who's sponsoring that tournament, has offered to come and talk to us on a similar session to this, along with Andy Butler from Parkinson's People, who's also said he'd sponsor a squad to attend. So the gauntlet's been put down for us now. I'm keen to get that team together. But in the meantime, promote table tennis as best you can for your groups. We've seen it's as good, if not better, than any of the drugs that are available at the minute to support us. So, it's got to be good. And you get the exercise thrown in for free. So I hope to run some more of these talks later on, as well as having monthly just informal natter sessions using the same medium. It's all on the Facebook and website pages, which you obviously found your way through that to get on this call. So just a final thanks really to all the panelists, attendees, supporters for making this possible. I look forward to having a game with all of you at some point over the coming weeks and months. And for our colleagues abroad as well, thank you for sharing and joining in, and we look forward to seeing you later on sometime next year.
Don't forget to tell them all as well that anything that they want to know, put it on Gone Active.
Oh yes, sorry, thank you. The blog where I'm just trying to capture sort of my learning and some of the points where you can find out those local resources as a self-help resource. And just to sharing all the good stories that we're finding from the people that many of them have been on tonight's call. So thank you. Thank you for supporting that, John. And everybody stay safe and speak to you again soon.
Andrew, could I just say something before we go? Because I just want to say thank you from Parkinson's UK, Andrew, for everything that you've done to drive this forward. And your sheer determination in bringing everyone together with this. I've kind of watched this from probably a year ago now, when I first met Andrew, and how this has picked up and gathered momentum. And thank you for bringing, you know, getting hooked up with Nenad and bringing all of these people together. It is absolutely inspirational, and it's a true reflection of Team Parkinson's and what we want that to be. So Andrew, thank you very much, and thanks all of you for sharing your stories as well.
Look forward to joining you again on another call. Thank you, Julie. Okay. Thanks everybody.
Bye.
It's bye.
If I had another life, I would never walk straight. All the things I love to do, other people love to hate. Wear my shoes on my ears, my head on my feet, park the car in the kitchen, take a bath in the street. I love ping pong, I love buns, I love the Three Stooges and those crazy drums. I like lovers who don't vote the same, and lying on my bed